Yeah, welcome guys. Welcome to our direct tax classes. Let's start a new topic in this lecture, which is very, very important for your examination. So please be careful. Today we are starting with concept of charitable trust. Concept of charitable trust. First rule first, which section covers this under Income Tax Act? Section 11 and Section 12 of Income Tax Act speaks about this topic. Section 11 and Section 12 speaks about this topic. Rule number 2, it's a Module 2 topic. I hope you know we have three modules, materials, for which this is your module 2 topic. You can open your module 2, you will find in the index concept of charitable trust. Third point, in our DT notes, it's from page 393 to 416, and majority I will be reading from the DT notes only. In our DT notes, that is your class notes, DT class notes, which are of 600 around pages, is from page 393 to 416. You have also have index, you can check in the index also. Next rule, it's a compulsory question in exam. Every attempt compulsory aata for 6 to 8 marks. Every attempt, yes sir, every attempt. It will take around 6 hours to 7 hours discussion on this charitable trust. Very, very important for your examination. Absolutely bloody important. 100% question will come in exam either in November 20, May 21, November, all three attempts it will come for 6 to 8 marks. Concept of charitable trust. Okay, shall we start? First rule, don't copy anything. Sunte jao phir. Intention of the act, intention of central government is to encourage charitable trust in India. From now, CT bolto charitable trust. CT bolto charitable trust. To encourage charitable trust in India. So, government says, if you satisfy 5 conditions, we will give you benefits under Income Tax Act. If you satisfy the 5 conditions given under Section 11 and Section 12 of the Income Tax Act, remember Section 10 is exempt income, 11 and 12 speaks about charitable trust. 13A speaks about political parties, 13B speaks about electoral trust, will be covered in subsequent lectures. If you satisfy these 5 conditions, we will get certain benefits. What are the conditions? Let us understand first overall, then we will jump into each condition in depth. Okay. First condition is registration. First condition is registration. Second condition is activities in India. Third condition is maintain an audit, books of accounts, and file return of income. Next one is application of income. And next one is investments. What are these? We'll cover in depth, don't worry. These are the 5 conditions we are talking about. If these 5 conditions are satisfied, government clarified income of charitable trust is exempt from tax. बोले तो there is no tax on charitable trust. But that concept will come only if this all five conditions are satisfied. What does each condition say? We have to cover in depth now. We have to cover in depth, we'll be covering depth. Income of cities exempt, garments is because they're not working, they're not earning for themselves, they're doing for public. Public as a whole is getting benefit. They are doing everything for Indian public. They want to serve the society. So they are not doing anything for themselves. They want to show the gratitude towards the public. So the income earned by them is exempt from Income Tax Act under Section 11 and Section 12 of Income Tax Act. What are the five conditions? Registrations, activities in India, maintain audit file return, application of income and investments. These five conditions has to be satisfied. Open page 393 of DT notes. You will find this chart only. Open page 393 DT notes. You'll find like this heading. Conditions, registration, activities, audit, application of income, investment. If you satisfy all this, income is exempt under Section 11 and 12. But these are overview conditions. Now we have to spend two and a half hours on each condition. Well, it will take 2.5 hours to complete all these five conditions. We have to go into deep for every condition and understand the logic of it. Okay. If you want a copy, you can copy this. 1 minute I'm giving you. ठीक है, स्टार्ट करें. नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट. नाउ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द कंडीशन सर. विल टॉक अबाउट द फर्स्ट कंडीशन देन. वी स्पीक्स अबाउट रजिस्ट्रेशन. Registration of what? My head. Registration of charitable trust. Registration of charitable trust. Please keep on listening first. Then we'll cover a few case laws also on registration. And 2-3 problems also recently asked only on registration of charitable trust. So no. Four friends. A, B, C, D. Assuming these are friends. Okay. Come together. They form a trust and their objective is to run free school for students. To run free school for the students. They form a trust. Trust bolt the group. Trust bolt the they form a group. Now they are called a trust or a group, but they will be called charitable trust only if they are registered with income tax department. They are called a trust till now, but they should be called as a charitable trust. In order to call a charitable trust, they need to be registered with income tax department. Understand the story like this. Four friends, they form a group. Their objective is to run the free school. Now, they enter into agreement. Like in partnership, it's called partnership deed. Here it's called trust deed. In the trust deed, they will mention the objectives of the trust. Like in memorandum, you will have objects clause, you will have capital clause, you will have subscription clause, you have name clause. Like this, in the trust deed, it's like a partnership deed. They will mention the objectives of the trust. And once the trust deed they form, they file an application in Form 10A to Commissioner of Income Tax. To Commissioner of Income Tax. So, if I want my trust to get registered, I want registration, I have to apply to Commissioner of Income Tax in Form 10A. This fellow has the power to grant me the registration. This fellow has the power. Four friends. These friends will be called from now as trustees or founders or promoters, one and same. Therefore, these people will be called as either trustees of the trust or the founders or the promoters. They form a trust or a group, then they enter into the agreement. They will mention the objects of the trust. My object is to run the free school. They file an application form 10A to charitable trust. I shall file application only after forming the trust deed. Only after formation of the trust. Yahan tak story clear? Next, first rule. Is there any time limit to file the application? Government says no time limit. Whenever you want to file application, you can file. Whenever you want to file application, you can file the application. Whenever you want to file. For example, I filed application in year 6. I filed application in year 6. Okay. Two things can happen. CIT accepted my application. CIT accepted my application. He said, okay, I will encourage you, please start a school and provide free education to students. Your application is accepted. If it is accepted, what now? What happens now? Government clarified, income of the city. Once it is accepted, now it will be called as charitable trust. Till before acceptance, it is only called as trust. Once the Commissioner of Income Tax accepts your application, it is called charitable trust. Income of the charitable trust will be exempt from year 6 and onwards. So, the moment my application is accepted, that year, say, till future, forever, my income of the charitable trust will be exempt, subject to other four conditions. Because first condition is satisfied, registration is satisfied. If my application is accepted, income of the charitable trust will be exempt from year 6 and onwards. For example, let us take me a date. I filed application on 30th January 2019 and my application is accepted, so my income will be exempt from financial year 18-19. This is 18-19 and onwards. So my entire income from 18-19, 19-20, 20 till future years, forever, perpetuity, going concern, is exempt if my application is accepted. Clear? CIT has 6 months time to take the decision. Commissioner of Income Tax will have 6 months time to take the decision. Which decision? Either to accept or reject the application. 6 months mein they should either accept or reject the application. Okay, next. I filed, my application is rejected. CIT should mention the reason of rejection. Why is my application rejected? And also provide OBH, opportunity of being heard. If my application is rejected, Commissioner of Income Tax should explain me why is the application rejected, and also provide opportunity of being heard to the applicant. Applicant bole do trust. Next, what does the option we have? Can I open? I felt it should be accepted, but that fellow rejected my application. Can I open the three doors, D1, D2, D3? Government clarified, you can open D1. That is CIT appeals. D2 was CIT under 264. D3 was section 154. You can open D1, CIT appeals. But later on, we'll cover appeals and revisions. Whenever you go to D1, there are four rooms. CIT appeals, ITAT, High Court, Supreme Court. You can directly go to D1, R2. But the government says you can file appeal to ITAT. Why I cannot go to CIT appeals? Because who rejected? CIT rejected. You cannot go to CIT appeals. Both are at the same level. So government wants you to go to higher level. You cannot complain. You cannot complain. If your mom is not listening to you, you cannot complain to your dad. You'll complain to your grandmom. Then definitely your mom will listen to you. Exactly the same way, CIT rejected the application. You cannot go to the same level of authority. You will go to the higher level. That is ITAT. Within 60 days, you can file the appeal. Within 60 days, you can file the appeal. No action was taken. Both neither accepted, neither rejected. 6 months also completed. Government, Supreme Court held a very famous judgment, deemed to be accepted. If the CIT neither accepts, neither rejects your application within 6 months, then the application will be deemed to be accepted. Your application will be deemed to be accepted. Remember this. Okay, yahan tak? Four friends, they form a trust, they enter the trust deed, mention the objects of the trust, run free school, file application to CIT. What is the time limit to file application? Note, whenever you want to file, you can file, and from that year onwards till forever, your income is exempt. Accepted, what now? Income charitable trust will be exempt from year 6 and onwards because I filed in year 6. Rejected, he will provide the OBH. I can file appeal to ITAT. No action within 6 months. Then what happens? Deemed to be accepted. यहाँ तक स्टोरी क्लियर? यहाँ तक स्टोरी क्लियर? ना लिसन, थोड़ा डेप्थ में लेके जाता हूँ. You want to copy as running notes, you can copy this. Then I'll take you into depth. Done, guys. चलो ठीक है ना लिसन, दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट कमिंग योर वे. चुपचाप सुनो प्लीज. आई फाइल एप्लीकेशन इन ईयर 6 एंड माय एप्लीकेशन इज एक्सेप्टेड. आई फाइल एप्लीकेशन इन ईयर 6, माय एप्लीकेशन इज एक्सेप्टेड. सो व्हाट हैपेंस नाउ? from year 6, year 7, year 8, year 9, year 10 till forever your income is exempt. This is year 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, dot, dot, 8, 9, 10. From year 6 till forever your income is exempt. Now the question is, what about the previous years or the last years? What about the previous years or last years? From year 1 to 5, I paid taxes on the income. From year 1 to 5, I paid taxes on income. Will I get refund now on those taxes? Government says you will not get refund. Why will you get refund? Because you were not charitable trust from year 1 to 5. You paid the tax as a trust, not as charitable trust, will not give you refund. Question is clear. Application is accepted in year 6. So income will be exempt from year 6 and future years. What about previous years, that is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1? I have paid some taxes. On that, I will not get refund from the government. Clear. But Arun Jaitley clarified. Income of last years will be also exempt. Income of last years. Last year, bolto, year 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be exempt if assessment is pending before AO. Assessment can happen under any one of these four sections, 143, 144, 147, 153A. Scrutiny assessment, Baja assessment, income escaping assessment, search assessment spending before AO and objects clause of the trust are same. If these two conditions are satisfied, assessment is pending, boleto, your scrutiny case is pending. Whenever assessment is pending, boleto, for year 1 to 5, department cannot ask you to pay the tax because you got the status as charitable trust. Charitable trust is a status like individual, HUF, company, firm, AOPBOI. Similarly, charitable trust is a status you will get only when you are registered with department. Who has the power to give registration? Commissioner of Income Tax has the power to give you the registration. Last time I repeat, chup chap sun lo. I filed in year 6. So year 6 onwards till forever your income is exempt. What about the back years 5, 4, 3, 2, 1? Generally I paid the taxes, I will not get refund. Close. But if your assessment is pending for those 5 years, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and the objects clause are same, department cannot ask you to pay tax on that because you have obtained the status of charitable trust. Income case should be pending before AO and objects clause should be same. My object clause is only one. I want to run a free school for students. But before accepting the application, one amendment has come. CIT shall ensure. CIT shall ensure the trust complies with other laws time being in force. Bolto that Commissioner of Income Tax also should make sure the trust is complying with other laws applicable to the charitable trust also. Then only he will give you the acceptance or CT certificate, charitable trust certificate. I shall form the application in form 10A, A for Apple. He has to ensure the trust complies with other laws time being in force. This is important point, nothing great you have in this. One more thing. What about last years? I already paid the taxes and not get refund, correct. But if the case is pending before assessing officer for any 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years, and objects clause are same, the assessment gets stopped there immediately. And in this case, AO cannot invoke, cannot section 147 provision, that is income escaping assessment. 147 also they cannot invoke. Okay, so ye copy kar lo ek bar, easy ho jata aapke liye. ठीक है, यहां तक डन? यस सर नो? चल नाउ डू वन थिंग. Everyone on page 394 of your DT notes. Bole to, just now we were talking about this particular chart, the first one. The next page, please. The next page. Okay. The next page. The first condition we are talking about is registration. The first section we are talking about is registration. Correct? Everyone, please. There are 9 points. We will cover this. We have few case laws also and few problems on registration. That also will complete. That will be completing the first condition, that is registration. Applicant, say 4 friends ABCD, form a trust, a group, enter into trust deed like partnership deed. My object is to run the school. I file application to Commissioner of Income Tax. The trust has to make an application in form 10A, we know that, along with the trust deed, along with the objects of the trust, what I want to do. Third, application can be filed only after formation of the trust. Bole to, unless and until you form, you enter the trust deed, you submit the trust deed, you cannot make an application only. Okay. What is the time limit to file application? There is no time limit to file the application. However, in whichever year you file the application and the application is accepted, from that year on, that year and future years, your income is exempt. However, exemption will be available from the financial year in which application is made. For example, The trust made an application on 30th January 19 and it get registration accepted. Income will be exempted from 18-19 and onwards. And onwards both the future years 19-20, 20-21, 22-20 subject to other four conditions. Point number 5. On receipt of application by CIT, CIT will examine the records. Will check the application. This is new law. This is new amendment. As per new amendment, CIT shall also ensure that the trust has complied with any other law for the time being in force. For example, if other laws are applicable, local laws applicable to charitable trust, CIT department also ensure that charitable trust is also complying with the other local laws applicable to the charitable trust. Three things can happen. He can accept my application, reject, no action within 6, he has 6 months and did not accept nor rejected. What happens if he rejects? He should give me the reasons, opportunity of being heard. I can file an appeal to ITAT within 60 days. Reject the application, remedy available, file to ITAT within 60 days. He did not take any action, no action taken within 6 months from the end of the month in which application is made, deemed to be accepted, and there is a case law for it, Society for Promotion of Education case law number 2, page 21. Come to case law material, page 21. Case law material, page 20 may have. You will find heading charitable or eligible trust. Number the case laws 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Sorry, 6 only. 6 case laws we have. Okay. We are talking about second case law. This one. This one. Society for Promotion of Education. And this is page number 21 of the case law material. This case law may Supreme Court held. CIT, you have 6 months time to either accept the application or reject. You neither accepted, you neither rejected. We'll treat it as deemed to be accepted. Check karo. So this case law is done. ठीक है चल नेक्स्ट माय एप्लीकेशन इज एक्सेप्टेड व्हाट हैपेंस इफ आई फाइल इन ईयर 6 माय इनकम फ्रॉम ईयर 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 फॉर एवर एग्जेम्प्ट व्हाट अबाउट लास्ट ईयर्स 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 व्हाट एवर टैक्सेस यू पेड यू विल नॉट गेट इन रिफंड दैट्स फॉर श्योर बट इनकम इज एग्जेम्प्ट बोल तो गवर्नमेंट कैन नॉट कलेक्ट एक्स्ट्रा टैक्सेस फ्रॉम यू फॉर दोज ईयर्स प्रोवाइडेड Your case is pending before AO and objects clause are same and AO also cannot invoke section 147 for year 1 to year 5. Consequences of registration. Exemption will be available from the financial year in which application is made. However, exemption shall also be available for earlier years, year 1 to 5, provided the case is pending before AO and objects clause of the trust are same. It has also been clarified that AO cannot invoke 147 to for earlier on the ground that trust has not obtained registration. I already covered this point with an example. 5 points are done. There are total 9 points on registration. 5 points are already done and dusted. Okay. Clear yahan tak? I am giving you exactly 3 minutes. Read 1 to 5 points. Sir, I will make you revise this topic in the class itself so that we are perfect in charitable trust and when we do problems in the next lecture, your problem should be very correct. 8 out of 8 I should get. To get that, we should have clarity over the concept. If you satisfy 5 conditions, that income of charitable trust is exempt. Out of 5, the first condition we are looking right now is registration. 3 minutes, please read these 5 points which we are covering right now. Start, please. Please jaldi read karo. ठीक है, चल लेट्स कंटिन्यू. पॉइंट नंबर सिक्स लिसन नाउ. रजिस्ट्रेशन कैन नॉट बी डिनाइड ऑन द ग्राउंड दैट एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द ट्रस्ट हैज नॉट बीन स्टार्टेड. नाउ इट मींस वी डिसाइडेड वी विल रन अ फ्री स्कूल. We can start the school and then take the registration, or we can take the registration first and then start the school. No problem in both the cases. We can start the school and then take the registration, or first we'll take the registration and then start the school. That's the meaning of registration cannot be denied on the ground that activities of the trust has not been started. Department cannot say, I will not accept your application because school you did not start. I will answer to him, waste fellow, you give the registration first, I'll start the free school. You cannot reject my application on the ground that school has not been started. I will reply, you first give the registration, then I will start the school. And this was held in a Supreme Court judgment in Meenakshi Amma endorsement, case law number 3. Page 21 of the case law material. Likho yahan. Case law number 3. Page 21 of the case law material. Come to page case law number 3. This one. Go through this. Bolto CIT cannot reject my application because I have not started the school. I will reply, you first give the registration, then I'll start the school. But you cannot reject on that ground that my school has not been started. Because I thought you give the registration, then only I'll start the school. So registration cannot be denied. Please read this properly. Important case law again. So these are very important topics for your examination. Trust me, charitable trust 100% her attempt mein aata. So please be careful. Please be careful, because when I start problems, you'll go mad only. So to do the problems today, these concepts are very helpful and useful. ठीक है, पढ़ लेना सर ये. चलो नेक्स्ट पॉइंट नंबर 7, मॉडिफिकेशंस इन द ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ द ट्रस्ट. मॉडिफिकेशंस इन द ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ द ट्रस्ट. आई फाइल्ड फॉर रजिस्ट्रेशन, देयर आई मेंशन माय ऑब्जेक्ट इज टू रन द फ्री स्कूल. आई गॉट द रजिस्ट्रेशन. आफ्टर 3 years, आई एम चेंजिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ माई ट्रस्ट from free school to providing free water bottles, free water to public. You're changing the objects of the trust. Before the objective was to run a free school. Now your objective has changed to provide free water to public. Government says if you're changing the objects, inform the department. Like whenever you change any clause in the memorandum of association, you have to inform the ROC whether the objects clause, the capital clause, subscription clause, name clause. Here you are changing the objects of the trust. You have to inform the department, that is commissioner of income tax, within 30 days. You have to inform. If you do not inform within 30 days or inform after, you have not informed only or informed after 30 days, then that year exemption I will take back from you, and that year you have to pay tax on the income. If you change the objects clause, inform the department within 30 days. I have not informed at all or informed after 30 days, that year we will take the benefit of exemption from you, and you have to pay tax on the income of the charitable trust. What will be the income of the charitable trust? 90% of the income of the trust will come from donations from public. That also will be covering in when we proceed. Now let's read. After granting of registration, if the charitable trust has modified the objects of the trust, bole to changing from running the school to providing free water to the public, which is not in accordance with the conditions of registration, the trust shall be required, underline the word shall, compulsory, be required to take fresh registration within 30 days from the change in the objects clause. If the fresh registration is not obtained, exemption of that financial year will not be available, although you have to pay tax on the income for that particular year. That's called modifications in the objects of the trust. Point number 8. Cancellation of registration of the trust. Bole to, who has the power to give you registration? CIT. Who will have the power to take back the registration? CIT. I want to go to Goa with my friends. I need approval from my wife. She said yes today, and she says no tomorrow. Then she says, when I can say yes, I also have the power to say no. Exactly the same way. CIT has the power to give you the registration. CIT will also have the power to cancel your registration. When will he cancel? 3-4 cases we will cancel. After granting registration, CIT has the power to cancel the registration if he is satisfied that activities of the trust are not genuine. Also, you are not running the school. Only you have a name board of the school. Nothing is happening inside. Activities are not in accordance with the objects of the trust. You told me you will run a free school and you are making AK-47 in that particular school. Activities are not genuine. And third one, CIT comes to know that charitable trust has violated any law for time being in force. If charitable trust violates other laws, not income tax act, other laws, we'll take back your registration. But before taking back, we'll give you opportunity of being heard before cancellation of registration. Okay, so this becomes point A, this becomes B, and this becomes C. A, B, C. Okay, cancellation of the registration by CIT. Okay. But before cancellation, OBA shall be given before cancellation of registration. Clear यहां तक? यहां तक clear? Okay. Fine. So cancellation is also properly done. OBA shall be given. Now right. Point D. A, B, C. One more point you write somewhere. D. In here. Likho. D. Registration can be cancelled. Registration can be cancelled on the basis of search conducted under section 132 point number D in this point number 8 next sub point. Okay, point number D. Registration be cancelled by CIT. Registration can be cancelled, or CIT can cancel the registration on the ground that CIT can cancel the registration on the ground that search has been conducted under section 132 in the premises of Secretary General, in the premises of Secretary General, and on the basis of statement recorded by him, and on the basis of statement recorded by him, and on the basis of statement recorded by him. ब्रैकेट में यूपी ऐसा ब्रैकेट में यूपीडीए वर्सेस सीआईटी केस लॉ यूपीडीए वर्सेस सीआईटी केस लॉ यूपीडीए वर्सेस सीआईटी केस लॉ CIT case law, page number 53, case law material. You can go through that. Page number 53, case law material. Page number 5353, case law material. ठीक है चल नेक्स्ट कैन चैरिटेबल ट्रस्ट क्लेम एग्जेम्पशन अंडर सेक्शन 10 मार्क एज इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट पॉइंट नंबर 9 दिस इज अंडर रजिस्ट्रेशन मार्क दिस एज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट कैन चैरिटेबल ट्रस्ट क्लेम एग्जेम्पशन अंडर सेक्शन 10 बोल तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इनकम ऑफ चैरिटेबल ट्रस्ट इज एग्जेम्प्ट एंड दे आर अर्निंग एग्जेम्प्ट इनकम इज दैट एग्जेम्प्ट Your Chidambaram clarified. So now, yeah, charitable trust earns agriculture income under 10(1), educational institution under 1023C. Those two incomes are exempt. Any other exempt income under section 10 is not exempt. It's like negative of negative if positive. Similarly, an exempt institution earning exempt income, only these two incomes are exempt and any other exempt income is not exempt. This is my analysis. See the Bayer Act language. As per 11th subsection 7, need not remember the subsections and all, charitable trust speaks about section 11 and 12. Where a trust has been granted registration under 12 and registration is in force in the previous year, then the trust cannot claim any exemption under any provisions of section 10 except 10(1) and 1023C. Cannot claim any exemption under section 10. except 10-1 and 10-23C. But the 10-1 is exempt, 10-23C exempt. Any other exempt income is not exempt. I am not telling this, government is telling me this. I till now do not know the logical reasoning behind this. But when we do problems, I can give you my interpretation why this concept has come into picture. Right now, you have to remember that. That's it. This point is important. Mark as very important point. This one. ठीक है, अब एक काम करो. दिस कंप्लीट द फर्स्ट कंडीशन दैट इज रजिस्ट्रेशन. अब यहां सुनो, यहां देखो क्या दे रहा. रिफर पेज नंबर 23, क्वेश्चन नंबर 13. ओपन प्लीज मॉड्यूल 2. आई रिपीट मॉड्यूल 2. यू विल फाइंड दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 13. Page number 23. Examine the validity of the below statement. Charitable trust institution cannot claim exemption under any provisions of the Act. False. They can claim exemption under 10-1 and 10-23C. Refer point number 9 under registration topic. Page 395 of DT notes. That's the answer. Tick mark the question. Refer point number 9 under registration topic in page 395 of DT notes. And answer for this is false. Yes or no? ठीक है, ठीक है. Next, come to question number 24, page number 30. Please read the question. This one. Page number 30, module 2, I repeat, module 2 we are in now. Read this. In this problem, the CIT did not accept nor rejected within 6 months from the end of the month in which application is made. So, your application will be deemed to be accepted. So, answer you have to write is refer case law number 2, page 21 of case law material. Society for Promotion of Education case law. That's the answer you have to write in the exam. Case law number 2, page number 21 of case law material. Society for Promotion of Education case law, which we already discussed. So this completed. ठीक है, अच्छा. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट नाउ. वंस अगेन लेट अस रिपीट. इफ यू सैटिस्फाई 5 कंडीशंस, योर इनकम ऑफ चैरिटेबल ट्रस्ट इज एग्जेम्प्ट. रजिस्ट्रेशन कंप्लीटेड. सेकेंड कंडीशन इज एक्टिविटीज बोले तो इफ यू टेक द रजिस्ट्रेशन फर्स्ट यू रजिस्टर फाइल द रजिस्ट्री फाइल फॉर एप्लीकेशन एंड रजिस्टर द चैरिटी हैज टू बी डन इन इंडिया यू टुक द रजिस्ट्रेशन एंड यू आर रनिंग अ फ्री स्कूल आउटसाइड इंडिया वी विल नॉट गिव यू बेनिफिट You took the registration, the free school has to be run in India. That is called activities in India. So, government says the school has to be in India. Sir, but you say, sir, I want to open a school in India also, outside India also. Then, if you want to open a school outside India, you have to take approval from CBDT, Central Board of Direct Taxes. You have to take approval from CBDT, Central Board of Direct Taxes. Next, can a foreign charitable trust in USA open a free school in India? Why will we have a problem? Our people should not open school outside India. They should open India so that the benefit should go to Indians. The beneficiary should be Indians. So, Indian charitable trust should do the charity in India. To do charity outside India, they have to take approval from CBDT. Can a foreign charitable trust do charity in India? Government welcomes them with garland, we have no problem. So that is called activities in India. Let us read. We are in page number 395 of your DT notes. Down. You will have activities in India. Yeah. This completes the first condition, sir. Now we are talking about the second condition. Roman number 2. Activities in India. What does it say? Activities of the charitable trust shall be confined only to India. Confined. However, they can do activities outside India with prior approval of CBDT. Okay. However, foreign charitable trust can also do activities in India. Am I clear? This is a very simple condition. No, and logical also. The school has to be in India. If you want to open a school outside India, you take approval from CBDT. A foreign charitable trust can open a school in India. We have no problem with that. So that completes the second condition. Third condition, every charitable trust shall maintain books of accounts. What shall they mention? They shall maintain the books of accounts. Who is giving the donations? From where are they getting the donations? What is the mode of donations? Everything they shall maintain. PAN of the person who donated the amount. That is PAN of donor. I donated to charitable trust. I am called donor. Charitable trust is called Dhoni, not Dhoni. Dhoni. So every charitable trust has to maintain books of accounts for their receipts and expenditures. The books of accounts shall be audited by a practicing chartered accountant. And every year they have to file return of income. They file return of income under section 139 subsection 4A of the Act. When we covered return of income and assessment procedures, we covered 139, 4A, 4B, 4C, 4D, 4E, 4F in the chart. 4A speaks about charitable trust. Third condition mein, 3 sub-points. Maintain books of accounts. Audit books of accounts. File the return within the due date. If you have not filed the return or filed after the due date, it means you have violated the conditions. If you have violated the conditions, you will not get this benefit. If you don't get this benefit, it means that year, your income is taxable. That year onwards, that year only. What if next year I file the return on the due date? Again exempt. So, if you violate this any one of these conditions, sir, we will not take back your registration. We will take back the exemption from you for that year. That year, you have to pay the tax. Next year, again we'll check this. Satisfied? Don't pay the tax. सिंपल। थर्ड कंडीशंस में 3 सब पॉइंट्स, मेंटेन, ऑडिट, फाइल द रिटर्न ऑफ इनकम। कम टू द नेक्स्ट पेज नाउ। चलो नॉलेज ऑडिट ऑफ बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स, लिसन, मेंटेन बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स, ऑडिट बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स, फाइल द रिटर्न अंडर 139(4)A ऑन और बिफोर 30th September। दीज आर द 3 सब पॉइंट्स। एज पर 13(9), एग्जेम्पशन रिटर्न शैल नॉट बी अवेलेबल इफ रिटर्न इज नॉट फाइल्ड ऑन और बिफोर ड्यू डेट अंडर 139(1). इफ यू डू नॉट मेंटेन बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स, डू नॉट ऑडिट और डू नॉट फाइल द रिटर्न बिफोर द ड्यू डेट, that year will take back the exemption and you have to pay tax on that income. But next year, if you again file the return on before the due date, again you will get the exemption. It has been clarified that exemption of that year will be taken back and not the registration. Will not take back the registration, will take back the exemption. However, exemption will be available next year subject to the fulfillment of the conditions. So third condition may we have 3 sub points, maintain books of accounts, audit books of accounts, file the return on or before the due date. If you do not do this, that year you have to pay tax on the income. We will not take back the registration, we will take back the exemption from you. Story clear? Story clear? Third condition is clear? Let us repeat. There are 5 conditions. First one, registration, which we covered in depth, 9 points we covered. Second one, activities in India, the charity has to be in India. Third one, maintain books of accounts, audit books of accounts, and file the return on or before the due date. And due date is mentioned under 139(1), and you file the return under 139(4)A for charitable trust. This is the most important condition, that is application of income. This we will spend around 1 hour time. Be very careful. Application of income. Not that clear? Chal, let's continue. Yeah, chup chap sunte jao. So the fourth condition. One second. Yeah, so the fourth condition what we have in charitable trust is the most important, that is application of income. Application of income. Please be careful. Please be careful. First, let us understand the Bayer Act language. Act says like this in this particular fourth. Not less than 85% of the income of the charitable trust shall be applied for charitable purposes. This is the fourth condition as per the Bayer Act language. Not less than 85% of the income of a charitable trust shall be applied for charitable purposes. Nothing I understood. First, let us break the sentence. Not less than 85% bole to minimum 85%. सिंपल लैंग्वेज ऑफ द इनकम ऑफ द चैरिटेबल ट्रस्ट बोले तो आई रिसीव 200 रुपीज डोनेशंस फ्रॉम पब्लिक, आई रिसीव 200 रुपीज डोनेशंस फ्रॉम पब्लिक, मिनिमम 85%, मिनिमम 85, हाउ मच, 170 रुपीज, मिनिमम दैट इज 170 रुपीज, शैल बी अप्लाइड स्पेंड, आई शैल स्पेंड दिस 170 रुपीज फॉर स्कूल चैरिटेबल पर्पस, माई चैरिटेबल पर्पस इज स्कूल, सो वेन आई रिसीव 200 रुपीज डोनेशंस फ्रॉम पब्लिक दिस कंडीशन इज मिनिमम 85%, मिनिमम 170 रुपीज आई शुड स्पेंड फॉर स्कूल, हाउ कैन आई स्पेंड फॉर स्कूल, फॉर बाइंग बेंचेस, परचेजिंग ऑफ बिल्डिंग, एग्जाम्पल इज सुना देन विल कवर इन डेप्थ, प्रोजेक्टर्स, सैलरी टू टीचर्स, I should spend this for school purpose, minimum 85. Minimum 170. Can I spend more than 170? Government says we have no problem because the word is using with not less than 85. If it's more than 85, we have no problem. It should be minimum 85. Spent. So first question is where should I spend? We will understand that first. First question we have to ask ourselves. Second, spend for which purpose? Charitable purpose. What do you mean by charitable purpose? Defined under section 215 of the Income Tax Act. Second, so we will spend next 1 hour understanding what do you mean by charitable purpose? What do you mean by the word applied or spent? First, we'll focus on the meaning of charitable purpose. Fourth condition says whatever donations you receive from public, uska minimum 85% you should spend for the object of the trust, that is running a school. You should spend for school, either buy buildings for the school, pay salaries, pay for benches, projectors, stationery, canteen, whatever, food for students, whatever it is. It should be spent for school. Now we will understand what do you mean by charitable purpose? What do you mean by the word applied or spent? Background clear. Is the background clear, please? Is the background clear? Shall we start? So two questions we are answering. Number one, what do you mean by the word spent? And what do you mean by the word charitable purpose? What do you mean by the word spent? What do you mean the word charitable? We'll first focus on charitable purpose. Okay, listen now. First, meaning of charitable purpose, section 2, subsection 15. It's a very important definition. Be careful. Meaning of charitable purpose, section 2, subsection 15. This is given in page 398 of your DT notes. A very big chart it is. I'll make it very easy. Chup chap yahan sunte jao. Page 398 of your DT notes, you will find this particular chart. Definition of charitable purpose. Now listen. The Act says, seven things we are including. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Charitable purpose means relief to poor. Bolto, if you're giving any relief to poor, giving free blankets to poor people, it's a charitable purpose. Free water bottle to poor people, charitable purpose. Medicines during corona kit you are giving, relief to poor. Education, I am running a school, that is education, it's a charitable purpose. You are running a yoga center, charitable purpose. Your objective is preservation of environment. Your objective is preservation of environment. This is also called charitable purpose. Medical relief. You are running a hospital. That is also charitable purpose. Sixth, preservation of monuments or historical places like Taj Mahal, Golconda, India Gate, preservation. And the last one, advancement of any object for general public utility. For general public utility. अब यहां से सुनते जाओ, यहां से these seven things are covered under the definition of charitable purpose. The first six are specific definitions. The seventh one will be called as general definition. Seventh one says you are doing any benefit to public which is not covered under 1 to 6 will be covered under 7. You are doing any benefit to public which is not covered under 1 to 6 will be covered under 7. That is called general definition. Any other object for the benefit of general public, that is general definition. So let us repeat these 7 definitions, then I will cover the Arun Jaitley's amendment happened 5 years back on this concept. What do you mean by charitable purpose? When do I say you are running a charity? When do I say you are running a charitable trust? You provide, you are doing relief to poor, you are doing education, you are doing yoga, preservation of environment, medical relief, you are running a hospital, Baswatkaram, Indo-American Baswatkaram, preservation of monuments, and anything you are doing for the benefit of general public, these 7 are called charitable purpose or charity. You should be into any one of these 7. 1 to 6 are specific cases. 7th one is general case. ठीक है? But 7th one के लिए you have one condition, only if. But the condition is only for the 7th one. The condition we have only for the 7th case. For the general definition you have a condition. If advancement of object general public utility is a charitable purpose only if we are raising money from business activities. We are raising money from business activities. We are raising money from business activities. And the percentage of business receipts on total, नहीं समझ में आता चुपचाप सुनते जाओ, does not exceed 20%. The percentage on business receipts on total does not exceed 20%. This condition has to be satisfied, then only it is called charitable purpose for the 7th case. 7th case has a condition. I know you have not understood it properly. Let me take one example and explain. Chup-chap, suno. Suno, sir. I will take beautiful examples and explain. Chup-chap, suno. I have received donations of 120. I am running a charitable trust. Okay, my object is the 7th case, general case. My object is any general public utility is my objective. Okay, I have received donations of 120. I'm also doing business, and whatever profit I'm getting, I will spend for that particular charity. From that I got $20 lakhs from my business income. Once again, I repeat, I am running a charitable trust. My objective is the seventh case, any general public utility objective. I do not fund the first six. I got donations of 120 from the public. I am also doing business. With that, I got 20 lakhs income. I am spending the entire income for the trust. Total is 140. What is percentage of business income on total? 20 by 140 into 100. 20 by 140 into 100. 14.28%. Is it exceeding 20%? No, that is what we wrote. It shall not, does not exceed 20%. Yes, it's not exceeding 20%. Then it is a charitable purpose. This percentage should not exceed 20%. If it does not exceed, very good, it's a charitable purpose. Let us take one more example. Receive donations of 120, business income of 40 lakhs. Total 160 lakhs. Now percentage will be 40 by 160 into 100, 25%. It is not a charitable purpose. Then the income will be taxable. If it's a charitable purpose, income is exempt. Which income? 160 lakhs income will be taxable. Because that condition is not satisfied. The condition says it shall not exceed 20%, but it is exceeding, so we will tax you on the income. Clear. But the condition kisko hai? Ye condition hai only for the seventh case. If you fall under the first six, whether that percentage is more than, less than 20% or more than 20% does not matter. The percentage we will check only if you fall under the seventh category. If you fall under the first six category, whether the percentage is up to 20 or more than 20 does not matter. It is a charitable purpose. For the seventh case, we check if it does not exceed 20%, it's a charitable trust purpose. More than 20%, it's not a charitable purpose. If it's a charitable purpose, exempt, not a charitable purpose, income is taxable. Clear with this? Let me take and now read it properly. Everyone on page number 398. Charitable purpose, 7 cases, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7th one is advertisement nahi hai wo, advancement hai. It's not advertisement, advancement. Advancement of any object of general public utility. Usme 2 trees. Such activities undertaken in the course of actual carrying out of such advancement of other public utility and the aggregate receipt from such activity or activities during the financial do not exceed 20% of the total receipts of the trust or institution, such activities, so on. For example, it means if you're doing business, if you're also getting donations and also doing business to help to spend for charitable purpose, the percentage of the business income on the total income shall not exceed 20%. It means in layman terms, minimum 80% of your income should be donations income. Another way of understanding, minimum 80% of the income should be donations and the balance can be from your business activities. Now, so now, flaw bracket, percentage of business income on total income, less than or equal to 20%, charitable purpose, 11-12 applies, exempt. More than 12%, not a charitable purpose, 11-12 not apply, not an exempt income. But this condition will check only for the seventh one. For the first six, shall be treated as charitable purpose even if it exceeds 20%. So, for the first six cases, whether it's less than 20, more than 20, we are least bothered. For the seventh one, it shall not exceed 20%. That we have to remember. For the 1 to 6, percentage does not matter. Seventh one, percentage matters. It shall not exceed 20%. What shall not exceed 20%? Percentage of business income on total income. You are getting revenue from two categories. One from donations, one from your business income. Like being human, also get incomes from donations and also from sale of t-shirts. That sale of t-shirts will be called business income. So percentage of business income on total income, it shall not exceed 20%. That condition is only for the seventh one. If the condition is not satisfied, will not take back the registration. Wapis Bolram will take back the exemption. Always remember, if you violate the conditions, registration will not be taken back, exemption will be taken back. Matlab, that year you have to pay the tax. Next year, if you satisfy the conditions, don't pay the tax. Will not take back the registration from you, will take back the exemption from you for that year. Next year again you satisfy, you take the exemption again. Clear? Read it once again. Ek bar ye read a chart read karo. 398 page. Quick. We'll do few problems on this. What are the six are specific, seventh one is general. What are the six specific? You can tell in any order. Education, relief to poor, yoga, preservation of monuments, preservation of environment, medical relief. These are specific points where we don't check the percentage. Seventh one, advancement of any general public utility. Well, anything you do for general public, not covered under 1 to 6. Condition under that, seventh one may, provided the percentage of business receipts on total shall not exceed 20%. Please read. Please read. प्लीज रीड. चलो ठीक है, पढ़ लिए. नाउ रीड दिस विद एग्जाम्पल्स आई हैव गिवन यू. एग्जाम्पल वन, एग्जाम्पल टू एंड सो ऑन. रीड दिस. ब्रैकेट में क्लियरली गिवन फॉर केस सेवन ऑब्जेक्टिव, फॉर केस सेवन ऑब्जेक्टिव. रीड दिस. ठीक है, ओके. एंड फॉर ईयर केस 1 to 6, वेदर द परसेंटेज इज लेस देन 20, मोर देन, इट डज नॉट मैटर, इट इज स्टिल एन एग्जेम्प्ट इनकम. क्लियर यहां तक? नाउ लिसन, लेट्स कंटिन्यू दैट स्टेटमेंट. इफ आई रिमेंबर, स्टेटमेंट वॉज दिस, स्टेटमेंट वॉज दिस, बी केयरफुल. स्टेटमेंट वॉज दिस, वी आर इन द फोर्थ कंडीशन, करेक्ट सर? यस. Not less than 85%, not less than 85 ante minimum 85 of the income of the trust shall be applied, spent for charitable purpose. Where should I spend charitable purpose? In those 7 categories, either free education, relief to poor, yoga, medical relief, preservation of monuments, environment, or 7th one, general public utility, with the condition that the percentage of businesses do not exceed 20%. There you have to spend the money. Okay, that is purpose. Applied, spent. I am running a free school. Is a school charitable purpose? Yes, education. Applied in school, where should I apply the 200? Out of 200, minimum 170 I should spend for the school. School mein kaha? Now come to page 396. Page 396. Page 396. Fourth condition we are starting. Application of income. Application of income. At least, not less than, bolto at least, 85% of the total income of the trust shall be applied for charitable purpose. Which section speaks about charitable purpose? Section 2, subsection 15 of the Income Tax Act. Section 2 speaks about definitions. In a financial year, applied, arrow mark, concept of application of income. Where should the charitable trust spend the money? I receive 200 donations for school. Where should I spend the 200 for school? We have to write. Capital expenditure. I purchased a building for the school purpose. I purchased a projector. I purchased laptops and computers for the school. Capital expenditure. Revenue expenditure. I am paying salaries for the school teachers. I am purchasing stationery, I am purchasing benches, fans, electricity, क्या बोलते inverters, all those things incurred for charitable purpose. Donation to another charitable trust. I donated some amount to Chiranjeevi Blood Bank. I donated some amount to Indo-American Baswatkaram Cancer Hospital. You can do that. Repayment of loan taken to acquire the capital asset. I took a loan for the building. I got donations. I am repaying the loan which was taken from the bank for the building. That also allowed. Payment of taxes. We are not talking about income tax. It can be any tax. Municipal taxes for the property. Professional taxes. Any taxes. Commitment of expenditure. Commitment also keeping aside the amount for future purpose. Keeping an amount right now for future purpose is called commitment of expenditure. That will be called as commitment of expenditure. So, this condition may, we should remember 3 points. Minimum 85% should be spent. Yes. For which purpose? Charitable purpose. What do you mean by charitable purpose? Section 2, subsection 15 defines it. 7 points we have in that. We have to remember that. Where should I spend? You can spend for capital expenditure for the school, revenue expenditure for the school, donations to other trust, repayment of loan you took for the school purpose, payment of any taxes, commitment of expenditures. You can spend that amount here, minimum 170. Can I spend more than 170? Government has no problem. What if I spend less than 170? Next lecture may I'll tell you what will happen. Don't ask me what will happen if I spend less than the next topic, next lecture may I tell you. Right now the condition is minimum 170, minimum 85%, not less than 85%, or at least 85%, whatever name you give in English, no problem. Clear till here. Chalo. Now this is important, mark this as important points. Concept of actual cost of the asset versus depreciation. Now listen. I purchased building for 150 rupees. Depreciation on the building is 15. 10% pay if I calculate. I purchased building. I got donations of 200. I purchased building out of which 150 rupees for the building. Depreciation on that at the rate of 10% is 15. So, government clarifies. Year 1, we are in. Charitable trust, you have an option to take 150 right now as a cost, or take depreciation of 15 right now and for future years. Either you can take the cost or the cost of the asset or the depreciation of the asset. We will not take the total. You cannot add these two. Bole to, for calculating amount spent, we will either take 150 in year 1 or we will take 15, assuming SLM method for year 1, 2 and 3. We will consider 150 as amount spent in year 1, or we will consider amount spent as 15 in year 1, 15 year 2, 15 year 3, 15 year 4 and so on. Choice is yours, charitable trust, which method you want to follow. Either tell us that you want to take 150 as amount spent in year 1, or tell us you want to take 15 in year 1, 15 or in year 2, 15 year 3, or if it's WDV method, every year the depreciation keeps on reducing 15, 13.5 and so on for the subsequent years. We will give you option, you follow any one of it. either take the entire cost right now as amount spent or take the depreciation on the asset as amount spent for this year and future years. Choice is yours. Choice is yours. Listen, the meaning, the language now. Where an asset, building, the cost of acquisition has been claimed as application of income. If I have taken 150 rupees as purchase of building in year 1, then no deduction by way of depreciation or otherwise in respect of such asset shall be allowed. I will not give you depreciation now because you have entire claim 150 as amount spent while computing the income of such year, and such depreciation shall not be considered as application of income while computing the income of any previous year. Iska matlab, if you purchase a building in year 1, you have an option. Take 150 as amount spent or take depreciation on 150 in year 1, year 2, year 3, year 4, year 5 or so on. Got donations of 200, building 150, capital expenditure. If I take that 150 as amount spent right now, no depreciation on 150 will be allowed. Refer question number 12, page number 22. Module 2, वापिस बोल रहा हूँ सर, module 2 में आता है ये सब. It's a module 2 topic. I need not repeat 100 times. It's a module 2 topic. Come to page number 22. Question number 12. This one, please read the question and answer. You can write here, refer page 397 DT notes. Please read the question. Answer is also given in the next page. Answer is given in the next page. ठीक है, आंसर पढ़ लेना सब. नाउ लेट अस डू फ्यू प्रॉब्लम्स. सेम पेज, क्वेश्चन नंबर 10. इट वाज आस्क्ड इन नवंबर 2016 फॉर 6 मार्क्स. ठीक है, लेट्स स्टार्ट. एन इंस्टीट्यूशन हैविंग योगा, इट इज अ स्पेसिफिक डेफिनेशन, करेक्ट नो? एंड इट फॉल्स अंडर 1 to 6 ओनली. It falls under 1 to 6 definition. It's a charitable purpose. It's a charitable purpose defined under section 2, subsection 15. 7 points we have and it falls under 1 to 6. Although we don't check the percentage. Its total receipts are 135 lakhs. Out of which receipts from the businesses or trading is 26.5 lakhs. Ek bar calculate karo. Percentage of business receipts. 26.5 by 135 into 100. Even though not required, just for my knowledge you do. 26.5 divided by 135 into 100. 19.62. Would the institution continue to retain its charitable status and eligible for exemption 11 if it applies to receipt towards its main objective? Listen, listen. Write the answer. Write the answer for the first one. First bit ka answer likho. Explain. Please note down the answers. Explain first bit answer. Explain definition of charitable purpose. Explain definition of charitable purpose. Section 2, subsection 15 in exam. Second point. The objective is yoga. Objective is yoga. It's a charitable purpose. It's a charitable purpose, irrespective of percentage of business receipts. Irrespective of percentage of business receipts. Clear. That's done. Answer first bit. What would your answer if the objective is advancement of general public utility? Here we check the condition. It should not exceed 20. It's not exceeding. It's 19.62 only. So right there. Second bit answer. Charitable purpose includes advancement of object. Charitable purpose includes advancement of object for general public utility only if the percentage of business receipts, only if the percentage of business receipts on total receipts do not exceed 20%. Do not exceed 20%. In the given case, it is only 19.62%. In the given case, it is only 19.62%. Therefore, it is a charitable purpose. And will retain its charitable status. Therefore, it's a charitable purpose. Will retain its charitable status. And exemption is available. And exemption is available. And exemption is available. Yeah, that clear? Sure, super. This was question number 10. We have one more question recently asked. Let's come to that. Question number 22. Page number 29. Module 2. Question number 22. Page 29, Module 2. Let's start. An institution having advancement of object of general public utility, 7th case. Main object is registered under 12A, total receipts are 50 lakhs, out of which business receipts are 15 lakhs. Therefore, percentage of business receipts, 15 by 50 into 100, it is 30%. And it exceeds 20%. Would the institution continue to retain? No. Because it's exceeding 20%. And exam you have to explain charitable purpose definition under section 2, subsection 15. You have to explain the definition of charitable purpose in 215 and then write as it exceeds, because condition is it shall not exceed 20%. It's exceeding 20%, it's not a charitable purpose. Would your answer be different if the main objective is yoga? It is a charitable purpose. Here, percentage is irrelevant. For cases 1 to 6, percentage less than 20, more than 20 does not matter. It is a charitable purpose. Seventh one, it's a charitable purpose only if the percentage does not exceed 20%. I hope I'm very clear now. You can read the question, copy whatever I have given here. But first explain the definition in the exam, and then if you write this, you will get full marks. Explain charitable purpose definition under section 2, subsection 15. First answer, it's not a charitable purpose because it's a seventh objective and your percentage is more than 20%. Second case, it's yoga. It's a charitable purpose irrespective of percentage. For 1 to 6, percentage does not matter or irrelevant. Make a note. ठीक है चलो क्वेश्चन 23 राइट देयर सेम क्वेश्चन जस्ट नाउ वी कवर्ड व्हिच वाज दैट वी कवर्ड जस्ट नाउ टेंथ वाला था कौन सा था रे अभी जो कवर कर रहे थे सेम एज टेंथ इट्स रिपीटेड क्वेश्चन दिस इज सेम क्वेश्चन है So, answer also will be remain same. 23 also done. Question is exactly same. So, I will not do it once again. Okay? Sure. Sure. Now, listen. Amendment we cover karenge. One second. I am downloading one amendment which happened recently. One second. One second, please. Yeah, fine, sir. So, let's continue. So, once again, we'll repeat. We are in a topic called charitable trust, section number 11 to 12. We have five conditions. We covered the first four. Registration. Unless you register with the department, you will not be called charitable trust. You have to file application form 10H with Commissioner of Income Tax. You have to do activities in India, then only we'll give you the benefit. You have to be transparent, maintain books of accounts, audit and inform the government about your income, about your donations and so on and file the return before the due date. You have not filed the return or filed after due date, then that year exemption will take back. You have to pay tax on the income. Fourth one, application of income. That is at least 85% shall be spent for charitable purpose. Ab logic suno sir. अब लॉजिक सुनो व्हाट डिड वी कवर व्हाट इज फोर्थ कंडीशन सेज रिसीव 200 डोनेशंस I shall minimum spend for school 170. Okay. I shall minimum spend for school 170. Minimum. Can I spend more than 170? No problem. Minimum 170. Now the question we are asking. I spend 170. You told 170. I spend 170 only. What to do with balance 30 rupees now? What to do with balance 30 rupees? Can I keep it in my locker in my house? Can I take this money and go to Goa with my wife for honeymoon? Government says no. You have to invest that 30 rupees. That is the fifth condition. Investments. Covered under section 11, subsection 5 of the Income Tax Act. Section 11, subsection 5 of Income Tax Act says the 30 should be invested. And the government is only giving where you should invest. Answer is given by 11 subsection 5. Where should I invest? I received 200. I spent 180 for school. Government says very good. What to do with 20? We have to go to this section. I received 200. I spent 200. Very good. Nothing is left. Don't do anything. I received 200. I spent 190 rupees. Very good. What to do with that 10 balance remaining? You should go to 11.5 and government says you should invest that remaining amount. Where should I invest? List is given. We have to cover the list now. Bag is the fifth condition ka background clear. Investment mein we have a list. There you should, government is telling there only you have to invest. No other option. Akkade invest cheyali. Wahi invest karna. Come to page 399 of DT notes. Come to page 399 of DT notes. You will have the fifth condition. Mode of investment. Section 11, subsection 5. Can you see one black color ink is given? This is an amendment happened which you have to copy in your notebook also because your notebook does not have this. This amendment took place 10 days back. That's why it's given separately. I'll dictate. Don't worry. Not more than 15%. Underline not more than 15%. Remember this. Fourth condition says not less than 85% shall be spent. And fifth condition says not more than 15% shall be invested. This is spent. In layman terms, what I understand is minimum 85 I should spend for school, maximum 15 I can invest. That's the meaning of this points with the BEARAC language. Minimum 85% I should spend for school, maximum 15% I can invest. Okay, sure. So underline the word not more than 15% and write maximum 15% then. Maximum 15% shall be invested by the charitable trust in the following modes. 7 points you will have. Checker 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Please go through that. There you can invest that amount. Need not by heart. Please go through. Then I will dictate the 8th point. Where can I invest that 30 rupees? I can buy properties. I can buy another building for school for future purpose. I can invest in units of mutual fund. I can invest the 30 rupees in the bonds of housing finance companies like NBFCs, like DHFL, HDFC. I can invest the 30 rupees in government saving certificates like National Saving Certificates, Kisan Vikas Patra, और दूसरे विकास पत्र, इंडिया विकास पत्र, आई कैन इन्वेस्ट द 30 रुपीज इन द शेड्स एंड डिपॉजिट्स ऑफ पब्लिक सेक्टर अंडरटेकिंग, लाइक आई कैन इन्वेस्ट इन शेड्स ऑफ NTPC, शेड्स ऑफ BHEL, आई कैन इन्वेस्ट द 30 रुपीज इन पोस्ट ऑफिस अकाउंट्स और शेड्यूल्ड बैंक्स, और आई कैन मेक एन FD विद दैट अमाउंट, बट इक्कड़े इन्वेस्ट चेयाली, यू कैन नॉट इन्वेस्ट बियॉन्ड दिस लिस्ट. यू इन्वेस्ट बियॉन्ड दिस लिस्ट, आई टेल यू व्हाट विल हैपन. 7 लिस्ट आर गिवन, 8th वन इज अमेंडमेंट. सो व्हाट वी आर टॉकिंग इज, यू रिसीव 200 डोनेशंस, यू आर रनिंग अ स्कूल, फोर्थ कंडीशन इज यू शुड स्पेंड मिनिमम 170 फॉर स्कूल, फिफ्थ कंडीशन इज 30 इज लेफ्ट ओवर, मैक्सिमम 30 यू शुड इन्वेस्ट, यू कैनॉट कीप इट आइडल, यू कैनॉट कीप in your locker, in your house, you should invest in any one of these 7 cases or combination of 7 cases also possible, yes possible, but not beyond these 7 cases. You should invest that amount for future of the trust. Theek hai, ek bar 7 cases padho, then I'll dictate the 8th one. Jaldi padho. ठीक है, पढ़ लिए 7 केसेस, नाउ राइट द 8th वन. 8th वन राइट समवेयर देयर ओनली, 7 केसेस यू हैव, राइट द 8th वन नाउ. इन्वेस्टमेंट इन, यू राइटिंग द 8th केस प्लीज, इन्वेस्टमेंट इन इक्विटी शेयर्स और डिबेंचर्स और बॉन्ड्स ऑफ अ कंपनी. Investment in equity shares or debentures or bonds of a company which is engaged in retail payment systems, which is engaged in retail payment systems or digital payment systems, engaged in retail payment systems or digital payment systems approved by RBI, approved by RBI, where 51%, where at least 51% of the shares of those companies, where at least 51% of shares of those companies shall be held by, where at least 51% of the shares of the company shall be held by NPCI, ब्रैकेट में नेशनल पेमेंट्स कॉरपोरेशन ऑफ इंडिया, NPCI, National Payments Corporation of India. National Payments Corporation of India. Clear? यहां तक स्टोरी क्लियर. दिस कंप्लीट्स द फाइव कंडीशंस. इट टुक अस अराउंड 2 hours 5 minutes टू ओनली कवर दोस फाइव कंडीशंस. इफ ऑल द फाइव कंडीशंस आर सेटिस्फाइड देन द इनकम ऑफ द ट्रस्ट इज एग्जेम्प्ट. नो नीड टू पे द टैक्स. व्हाट आर दोस फाइव कंडीशन? क्लोज योर आईज एंड रिपीट. रजिस्ट्रेशन, एक्टिविटीज इन इंडिया, बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स, मेंटेन ऑडिट, फाइलिंग द रिटर्न बिफोर द ड्यू डेट. Minimum 85 shall be spent for charitable purpose. Charitable purpose defined under section 2, subsection 15 of the Income Tax Act. Maximum 15% shall be invested in those 8 cases. 7 we had, 1 is the amendment in those 8 cases. If all these 5 conditions are satisfied, then income of the charitable trust is exempt from tax under section 11 and 12 of the Income Tax Act. Am I very clear till here? Okay, sure. Now please come to page 400. There are small topics we have which will complete that, and then I'll tell you what we have to do. Okay. We are starting with this concept now. Procedure for excess accumulation. Procedure for excess accumulation. Ab suno, uska logic samjhaye tum pehle. Section 11, subsection 2 we are talking about. Procedure for excess accumulation. Listen now. I received 200 donations as per the act. I should minimum spend 170. I can maximum invest 30. Actually, I only spent 150. Balance is 50. I want to invest, but as per the act you can maximum invest 30 only, but I want to invest 50. Difference is 20 extra investment I want to do. I spent only 150, I want to invest 50, act is allowing only 30, but I want to do extra investment 20. This section is telling you what to do. Can I do this extra investment? This section says yes, but you have to satisfy the conditions. What are the conditions? First is you inform AO. Who should inform? Charitable trust should inform AO that we want to invest extra 20 rupees. Second, when should I inform AO? On or before the due date of filing return of income. That's the rule. If you want to invest more than what is required, you have to inform AO. Eppudu inform cheyali? On or before the due date, and that extra 20 shall be invested in 11 5 modes only, those 8 cases. This 20 rupees you have to invest in those 8 cases only, clear, and I should also inform the AO the purpose and the period of accumulation, why I want to invest and for how many years I want to invest. I can invest for maximum 5 years. So let us repeat once again, chip chap suno. I want to invest extra 20 rupees, that is called excess accumulation. This 20 rupees is called excess accumulation. I should inform you the purpose, why I am doing this, period of investment not more than 5 years, on or before the due date of filing return of income. I shall invest the 20 rupees in the 11.5 modes only. This 30 rupees also in that 11.5 modes, this 20 rupees also in 11.5 modes only. And next, this 20 rupees cannot be donated to other charitable trust. This is the rule. I should inform the AO regarding the purpose and the period, and the most important condition is I should inform before this date. On or before the due date of filing the return of income. Bole to, if filed after the due date, or if informed after the due date, if informed after the due date, then what happens? Exemption will be taken back. Although you have to pay tax on that income, yes, you have to pay tax on that. We are not taking the registration back, we are taking the exemption for that year. Clear? Copy this somewhere and then read from page 400 of DT notes. Okay, page 400 of DT notes. So can I do extra investment? Yes. Inform AO, purpose inform karo, period inform karo, maximum period allowed is 5 years. Kab inform karna? Before the due date of filing return of income. And what should I do with the 20 rupees? I should invest in those 8 cases only. That's the rule. It means, can I invest more than 15%? Yes, if these conditions are satisfied. Fifth condition says maximum 15, but 11th subsection 2 says you can invest more than 15 also. Inform the AO and all that nonsense will apply. If I copy color, then we'll read. Hello, my testing, check, check, hello, check, 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 check. ठीक है, हो गया। चल नालेशन पेज 400 ऑफ डीटी नोट्स, यू विल फाइंड दिस सेक्शन, सेक्शन 11 सब सेक्शन 2 प्रोसीजर फॉर एक्सेस अक्यूमुलेशन। चेक करो मिल रहा क्या। प्रोसीजर फॉर एक्सेस अक्यूमुलेशन दिखा। चलो As per 11 subsection 2, where 85% of income is not applied, but accumulated or set apart, then such accumulated income shall not be included in total income. That bracket mein charitable trust can invest more than 15%, subject to following conditions. SEC shall furnish a statement to AO stating the purpose and the period for which such income is accumulated, maximum period 5 years, kab, on or before the due date of filing the return of income. Such money, that excess money, shall be deposited in the modes prescribed under 11.5, that is fifth condition ke modes, 7 plus 1, 8 modes. Such money shall not be donated to another charitable trust. Note, exemption 11.2 will not be available if SEC files a statement to AO for excess accumulation after the due date, because the condition is you should inform the AO before the due date of filing return of income. Clear. Fifth condition says you can invest maximum 15%. This section says you can invest more than 15% provided inform the AO regarding the purpose, period, maximum for 5 years you can do that. When you should inform before the due date filing return of income, and you should invest that extra amount in that 11 subsection 5 modes only. Then it's fine. Clear? Chalo. Next. Next concept suno. Concept of income not received or late received. Concept of income not received or late received. इसका मतलब क्या है समझो पहले आप। यहां देखो listen now. We are in financial year 1920. ठीक है। I received donations of 200. I spent 170 for school. I invested 30 rupees in units of UTI. You have satisfied the conditions. Minimum spent 170, I spent maximum, I should invest 30, I invested 30, not more than that. On 31st March 2020, last day of the financial year, my friend gave an online donation. My charitable trust has a website www.charitabletrust.organization where I have mentioned the account details of the charitable trust so that anyone can donate. My friend donated 100 rupees at 10 o'clock. IMPS he did. Now, government cannot expect me that 10 o'clock, I slept at 9 o'clock only and I saw the message in my mobile phone the next day. So government cannot expect me that I have only 2 hours left now, 10 p.m., 11 and 12, because after that 1st April will start. In these 2 hours, I should spend 85 rupees and invest 15 rupees. That's not practically possible. That's not practical because I have only 2 hours left. And what if I saw the message next day? I slept at 8 o'clock only on that particular day. So government thought it's a practical problem. What if you are receiving the donations on the last day of the financial year? You will not have time to spend. You will not have time to invest. So government clarified these 100 rupees will be treated as donations of the next year. that is not 1920 but 2021, and you should invest this amount or spend this amount in 2021. 85% should be spent, 15% can be invested. That is called concept of income not received or late received. Not received bolto, he gave me a check at 10 p.m. I recorded in my books of accounts, given to bank, reflected in my bank account on 3rd April. Income not received. Income late received is this example. Income not received, check received now, realized later on. Income not received. This is income late received. So in that cases, that amount will be treated as amount received in the next year, and you have to spend 85% of that in the next year and invest 15% of that in the next year and not in this year. Clarification by the government. Sure. Let's understand now. In such cases, SSE can apply such income in the next financial year, provided application is filed to AO on or before. So I can spend this, this will be treated as donation for the next year, provided you inform the department, this was the scenario and I was not in a position to spend that in the 2 hours which was left. Inform them and treat that as donations of the next year, spend 85% of that in the next year, invest 15% of that in the next year. That is called income not received or income late received. Clear with this? Read it once again. If you want to copy this example there in your notebook, in page number 400, you can copy. Okay, sure. Now be careful. Now we are coming to the very, very important concept, practically important. Exam point of view also very important. Listen now. Now the most important topic in charitable trust is this concept of ANON, YMOUS, anonymous donations. Concept of anonymous donations. One second. Concept of anonymous donation. This we will read with section 2, subsection 24, clause 2A. Read with 115 BBC. Given in page 400 of DT notes. Do not read until I complete. If you want to copy this, you can copy, then we'll read from the notes also. Okay. Listen now. First one. What do you mean by anonymous donations? AD, anonymous donation. It is defined under section 2, subsection 24, clause 2A. Any definition in the Income Tax Act is under section 2, subsection you not remember for exam point of view. Anonymous donation means if charitable trust do not record or mention the name, the PAN and the address of the donor in their books of accounts. Please understand, whenever public, this is public, donates to charitable trust, it is the duty of the trust to mention the name and the PAN in their books of accounts. So charitable, for example, I donated some 5 lakhs to a charitable trust. It is the duty of the trust to mention my name and my PAN in their books of accounts. I am the donor, they are the donee. I am donating the amount. The charitable trust has to record my name and my PAN in their books of accounts. That is the rule. If they do, well and good. If they do not do, that is called anonymous donation. And we discourage anonymous donations. We don't want that to happen. We want the charitable trust to record the name of the donor. You have not recorded. We discourage those events. How do we discourage that events? Section 115 BBC was introduced, which says the tax is 30% on anonymous donations. Because you made a big mistake, Mr. Charitable Trust. You have not recorded the name and the PAN. It's like Benami property we have. It's like a Benami donations. Without name, without address, without PAN of the donor. Then if you do that, you have to pay tax at a flat rate of 30%. Flat rate voltage. But one benefit is given. Benefit is you get a deduction. Deduction is equals to 5% of the total donations or 1 lakh, whichever is higher, not lower, higher. Uska deduction you will get, then tax rate is 30% after deduction. Bole to, I received 3 lakhs as anonymous donation. Deduction will be 5% of that amount, 15,000. Or 1 lakh, whichever is higher, deduction will be 1 lakh. Balance 2 lakhs. This pay you have to pay tax at 30%. 60,000. Ye deduction kaisa aaya? 5% of 3 lakhs or 1 lakh, whichever is higher. क्लियर यहां तक? यस और नो बोलो रे. क्लियर यहां तक? नाउ लिसन, यू रिसीव्ड एनोनिमस डोनेशन 3 lakhs. यू स्पेंट फॉर स्कूल ओनली, फॉर परचेज ऑफ बिल्डिंग. You have a copy of that also. All the bills you have, still does not matter, taxable at 30%. You have utilized its 3 lakhs for your charity only. Does not matter. Who told you not to record the name, address and PAN of the donor? What you do with this 3 lakhs is irrelevant. We will tax you at 30%. Whether you have spent that amount for the charity or not, immaterial, does not matter, it is taxable at 30%. taxable at 30% even if the amount is actually spent for charitable purpose. Tax at 30%. CPE बोलता charitable purpose. एक बार ये कॉपी करो बेर एक्ट में, देन विल गो इनटू डेप्थ. Please sir, again I am repeating, this is your lecture number 1 in charitable trust, but before watching lecture number 2, you have to revise all this what is covered in lecture 1, then only you can do problems in lecture number 2 when we start in lecture number 2 for charitable purpose or charitable trust. Please jaldi copy karo ye. Five minutes I am giving you, copy. Chalo, please sir, start copying. You have this in page 400 also of your DT notes. Still I am asking you to copy, because if you write, it will be stored in your memory card for more period of time. हो गया कैसा चेक कर. ठीक है, चलो नॉलेज है, कम टू पेज 400, दिस इज व्हाट वी हैव. द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट इज कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एनोनिमस डोनेशंस. कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एनोनिमस डोनेशंस सेक्शन 2 सब सेक्शन 24 एंड ऑल. 4 ट्रीज, इंटेंशन इज डिस्करेज. मीनिंग इज यू हैव नॉट रिकॉर्ड द नेम एड्रेस एंड पैन ऑफ द डोनर, योर द डोनेशन इज कॉल्ड एनोनिमस. डिडक्शन इज 5% और 1 lakh, विच एवर इज हायर. एंड टैक्स रेट इज 30% एंड 115 BBC आफ्टर क्लेमिंग द डिडक्शन. रिमेंबर, डिडक्शन इज विच 5% और 1 lakh, विच एवर इज लोअर, नहीं विच एवर इज हायर. रिमेंबर दैट वर्ड, इट्स हायर हियर नॉट लोअर. ओके, नेक्स्ट, नोट पॉइंट्स ऑन एनोनिमस डोनेशंस. Note points on anonymous donations. If it is received by religious organization like temples, for example, whenever you go to temple, church, mosque, you give your offerings in a hundi, the pandit will not ask, hey, wait, give me your name, address and PAN. That's not practically possible. You go to Tirupati Balaji, line will be there. You donate something out of your gratitude, out of your offerings to the God. If it is received by religious organization like temple, church and all, those are exempt. Because it's not practically possible for the priest or for the pandit to stop everyone and say, hey, give me your PAN card, give me your name, give your address, how much you donated, how much you gave in hundi, tell us. That's not possible. So those are exempt, or we say not taxable. Received by only charitable trust, Being Human, Chiranjeevi Foundation, Indo-American Cancer Research Hospital, Baswatkaram, they are called only charitable trust, taxable. Partly religious, partly charitable trust. They are partly religious, partly charitable trust. Then we check if they are in education sector, hospital sector. If they are partly religious and partly charitable and they are into education and hospital, anonymous donations are taxable. Any other case, anonymous donations are exempt. Here, taxable, exempt. Please read this note point 1, important. This note point 1 is important, so please read. Please read. ठीक है, चल. सो दिस कंप्लीट्स कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एनोनिमस डोनेशंस. दिस कंप्लीट्स द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एनोनिमस डोनेशंस. क्लियर यहां तक? नेक्स्ट वी हैव वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट कॉल्ड कॉर्पस डोनेशंस. जस्ट नाउ वी कंप्लीट एनोनिमस डोनेशंस, नाउ वी हैव अ कॉन्सेप्ट कॉल्ड कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ कॉर्पस donations. Now what is this corpus? Let us understand. Now listen. Concept of corpus donations. Now listen. I am running a school. X donated 10 lakhs. Y donated 20 lakhs. if I do not record the name, address and PAN of these, they are called anonymous. But I recorded the name, PAN and address, no problem. Why told? I will give 20 lakhs only. The 20 lakhs are used for benches only. Then only I will give 20 lakhs. Why is donating with a condition? Condition is the 20 lakhs has to be spent for benches. Except you use the 10 lakhs, whatever you want. Benches, building, projectors, stationery, whatever you want. I will not tell you. That's your choice. Why is telling? It's a condition. So this 20 lakhs is called corpus donations. This 20 lakhs will be called as corpus donation with made with a specific directions and it is not taxable. It is not taxable. Bolto, when I calculate my donations, it will be 10 plus 20 will be 10 only. Will be 10 only. Because then out of this 10, 85 should spend for school because 20 will be spent for benches only. So my taxable donations amount will be 10 lakhs. The 20 lakhs will not be taxable. Am I clear? Clear? Now read this. It refers to donations given for specific purpose, benches. X gave 10 lakhs, Y gave 10 lakhs, X ka condition nahi hai, Y condition that it should be used for only for building, I took benches example, corpus donation exempt from tax. Corpus donation do not form part of total income of the trust. So donations will be 10 plus 10, it will be 10 only. This is important, mark this point as important. Can one charitable trust gives donation to another charitable trust? One charitable trust donation to another charitable trust, yes, but one charitable trust cannot do corpus donation to another charitable trust. Bolto, when you are, for example, I am a school running a charitable trust, I give donations to Indo-American Baswatkaram 10 lakhs and told him that you should purchase X-ray machine only with the 10 lakhs. That is not allowed. A charitable trust can give donations to another charitable trust. Another charitable trust will decide where to utilize. But a charitable trust cannot make corpus donation to another charitable trust. You cannot donate to the other trust with a condition. That is not allowed. If you do that, we will not treat that as application of income. What is that? I'll tell you later on. That's the meaning. One charitable trust cannot do corpus donation to another charitable trust, but one charitable trust can do normal donations to a charitable trust. Two types of donations we have: anonymous donations, where you do not record the name, address, and PAN of the donor, corpus donation, where a donor is giving donations to the trust with a specific direction that the amount shall be utilized for that particular purpose only. This completes corpus donations concept. Now your homework मैं अभी बोल देता हूँ क्या है 393 till 401 page 393 to page 401 of your DT notes. You have to read at least two times before watching the next lecture. अभी बोल दे रहा हूँ वरना next lecture नहीं समझ में आता. That is what we covered in the current lecture. Page 393 to page 401. You should read minimum two times, which has five conditions, which have corpus donation concept, anonymous donation concept, concept of income late received, not received, and excess accumulation concept under section 11, subsection 2. You have to read. Please, I am requesting, folding my hands, अच्छे से पढ़ लेना. Before you start watching the next lecture on charitable trust, very very important concept will be covered in the next lecture, because next lecture may we are starting with the problems. Clear? Have a nice day. See you in the next video. Thank you so much. Keep smiling.